Hello, my name is Marloes Mul and I'm an Associate Professor of Water Resources Management at IHE Delft. Today I'm going to discuss the WaPOR data format and metadata. First of all, you can find information about data format and metadata of all WaPOR data layers in the WaPOR portal. When selecting a data component, you will find the description box all the metadata information. Here is the list of the metadata information you can find there. The description will tell you what the data represent. All the WaPOR datasets are raster provided in GeoTIFF formats. The units are different for water, biomass and water productivity, and make sure you know the unit when you do calculation or conversions to other units. The data type is often integer for saving storage space and faster downloading speed. Therefore, a factor or multiplier is needed to convert the data into a float data type. No data value indicates the grid or pixels with estimations, thus needs to be masked. In addition, some data may have quality issues and therefore a quality flag. You will also find spatial and temporal resolution and extent of the data layer. Spatial reference system is important for map projection. You might notice that WaPOR level 1 and level 2 data use global geographic coordinate system, while level 3 uses regional projected coordinate system, UTM. The methodology contains a brief description on how the data was derived. For more information, you can read the database methodology report. The WaPOR database is continuously updated with new data. Some data components are near real time. You can find the information on how the latest decade or month data was delivered in the metadata. Understanding metadata is important for further analysis. For example, if you want to calculate actual evapotranspiration interception of a decade, you will need to multiply the collected raster with a multiplication factor and a number of days in decades because, in this case, the data represents an average daily value. Notice that the number of days in a decade is not always 10. For the last decade of the month, the number of days in a decade can be anywhere between 8 to 11, depending on the length of the month. You might also need to mask no data values out of the raster calculation. In the new WaPOR version, the scale factor is stored in the GeoTIFF metadata, meaning that the scaling factor is automatically applied in most GIS softwares. But when utilizing the raw data with programming languages, be sure the scaling factor is applied. Here an example of the WaPOR data source detail of the level 1 annual data of AETI is provided. It provides, for instance, the format, the bounding box, the naming convention, and the spatial reference system. Here you find an overview of the different data units for the different layers. Except for the decadal layer, the unit is the per-day time step of the temporal resolution of the layer. The decadal values are provided in average values per day, and when you need the total value for the decade, you have to multiply the value with the number of days in that decade. Also here you can see the scaling factor for each of the layers. Some additional information related to the naming convention of the WaPOR data is provided here. The name of the files consists of three parts. Part 1 is the level or the spatial resolution of the data. And remember that each level covers different areas, with the lowest resolution, level 1, being available globally. The second part, indicated in yellow here, is the data type. The list below presents the different naming conventions for each of the WaPOR layers. The last part of the name relates to the time step of the data. Finally, for the level 3 data, the name of the location is also included in each of the file names. At the moment, there are 30 areas with high resolution data. Each location has a specific 3-letter indicator. Thank you for your attention.